Our today's topic is 8051 programming in embedded C as a part of microcontroller and its application subject under chapter 2. We are discussing these various things. Out of that, now we will have an introduction about embedded C and how this particular platform is useful for programming using 8051 microcontroller. As all of we know that C is a type of computer programming language originally developed by Dennis Ritchie at AT&T Bell Laboratories in the year 1971 around. It has free format as far as programming is considered, and the source code we can write. Embedded C is a kind of extension of C. C Standards Committee has developed it or introduced it, we can see, for the purpose of programming with microcontroller. C is a type of computer programming language which was originally written using some statements, some kind of operators, some constructs, blocks of statements. It facilitates the structured programming approach and helps to design and provide solutions. It allows lexical variable scope and recursion, and it has a static type system which prevents many unintended operations. So C is one of the oldest programming language constantly used in the applications that had previously coded in assembly language, like Unix computer operating system based even applications, and has directly or indirectly influenced a lot of later programming languages like C Sharp, Java, JavaScript, LPC, PHP, Python, and Unix based C Shell. So n number of. So this is actually the power of C language and a kind of a impact and influence. And embedded C has been derived from this original C as a set of language extension. It was released by C Standards Committee in the form of embedded C. The most of the syntax and semantics are same as standard C. That is main function, variable definition, data type declaration, conditional statements like if, switch, case, then loops, while, for, functions, arrays, strings, structures, union, bit operation, macros. So many more. All these are belonging to original C, and they are all available in this extension called embedded C. Embedded C programming requires non-standard extensions to the C language. These features include fixed point arithmetic, multiple memory banks, then basic IO operations. And as embedded C is generally in the extension form, all these things are made available and possible for the programming purpose using microcontroller. So number of benefits are there as far as considered embedded C. Like C is in general used for desktop computers, and while this is used for controller based applications, that is embedded C. C can use the resources of PCs like memory, OS, everything. Embedded C is having kind of a limitations as far as these resources of embedded processor is considered. Embedded C includes extra features over C, such as fixed point types and multiple memory areas and IO register mapping. Compilers for C typically generate OS dependent executable kind of a stuff. Embedded C requires compilers to create files to be downloaded to the microcontroller or microprocessor where it needs to run, like OTP flash kind of support kind of platform is used, and that hex file is downloaded. So n number of such features are there. As a part of our this session, what is embedded C? So on that I just gave you the introduction, and now as an objective I would like to illustrate some of the features of embedded C with the help of some small sample programs. Also we will go through the data types and we will make use of them in our these simple sample programs. Compilers are there. They are responsible for producing hex files that is downloaded to ROM of microcontroller. The size of this hex file is the main concern, and the microcontrollers have limited on-chip ROM. Code space of 8051 is limited to 64 kilobytes. C programming is less time consuming but has larger hex file size. The reasons for writing programs in C is it is easier and less time consuming to write as compared to assembly language. It is easier to modify and update, and you can use the code available in the function libraries, and it is portable one to other microcontroller with little or no modification you can use it. So reusable feature is also there. So these are some of the benefits we get, and that's why it is kind of a popular format. A good understanding of C data types for 8051 can help programmer to create smaller hex files. Unsigned character, signed character, unsigned integer, signed integer, S-bit, that is a single bit, and bit and SFR. These are some of the data types. It is a 8051 microcontroller, so character data type is the most natural choice for many applications. The unsigned character is an 8-bit data type that takes a value in the range 0 to 255. It is one of the most widely used data type for 8051. In many situations such as setting the counter value where there is no need of signed data, we can use unsigned character instead of signed character. One thing you have to remember here that C compilers use the signed character as default if we do not put the keyword unsigned in front of the character. In general, while declaring the variables, we must pay careful attention to the size of the data and try to use unsigned character instead of integer if possible. Because 8051 has a limited number of registers and data RAM locations, using the integer in place of character data type can lead to a large size of hex file. So therefore, comparatively, unsigned character is preferred data type over integer. So this is one small program just I have written. Just saw simple two lines for toggling purpose. Now we have to remember that for all these programs, as a first line hash include, we have to include the respective header. So here for 8051 controller, you have to write here reg51.h. In case of peak, you have to write with peak, and so on. Now void main, just for loop, it goes on like that. And p1 equal to 0x55, p1 equal to 0xA. I have not added any delay in between. So just continuous toggling kind of a thing will happen with this small program. Signed character is 8-bit data type. Use MSB D7 to represent minus or plus, that is sign bit. Give us values from minus 128 to plus 127. We should stick with the unsigned character unless the data needs to be represented as signed number. So in general, any word like here, for example, I have written temperature. So it is unsigned character. You can use as a container name. The unsigned integer is a 16-bit data type. Takes value in the range of 0 to 65535, that is 0000 to FFFF. Define 16-bit variables such as memory addresses. Set counter values of more than 256, you can use this. Since registers and memory accesses are in 8-bit chunks, the misuse of integer variables will result in the larger hex file. So this you have to remember. Signed integer is a 16-bit data type that uses MSB D15 bit to represent minus or plus, that is a sign of that data. We have 15 bits for the magnitude of the number from minus 32768 to plus 32767. Now this is again one more example. we are supposed to write a small C program to toggle the bit D0 of the port P1. So instead of entire port, here we are using single port. I want to show you that S bit data type. So S bit keyword allows access to the single bit of respective SFR register. Now here my SFR is associated with P1 port, and out of that P1.0. So in embedded C, you see that a symbol of a kind of a cap operator, which we use for race 2 purpose. So that operator is used, P1.0 instead of that. Void main, unsigned integer, say for example one variable I have used Z, and for Z equal to 0 to Z less than 50,000, Z plus plus. So this much times it will go on doing that. And my bit equal to 0 and my bit equal to 1. So once it will be off, and then immediately it will be on. I have not added any delay in between. The bit data type allows access to single bits of bit addressable memory spaces, and that is from 20 to 2FH. To access the byte size SFR registers, we use SFR data type. So this is a summary as far as data types are considered. Unsigned character 8 bit 0 to 255, signed character 8 bit -128 to +127, unsigned integer 16 bit 0 to 65535, signed integer 16 bit -32768 to +32767. S bit is 1 bit SFR bit addressable only, bit only bit, that is 1 bit RAM bit addressable only, and SFR has 8 bit in size. It is RAM addresses 82FFH only. So there are two ways to create a time delay in 8051. First thing is using timer, and the second thing is using a simple for loop. Be mindful of three factors that can affect the accuracy of the delay. That is the 8051 design, number of machine cycles, the number of clock periods per machine cycle, the crystal frequency connected to the X1, X2 input pins, and compiler choice. C compiler converts C statements and functions to assembly language instructions. Different compiler produce different code. So, and again, accordingly the timeout. So that also is all to be remembered. Now, this is one small program where I have added the delay routine in the simplest way using for loop. See here, the program is 8051 C program to toggle bits P1 ports continuously with 250 milliseconds. We have inserted the delay. This is our first program for toggling. Now, as a beginning, hash include register 51.h, reg 51.h, void, ms delay, unsigned integer we have used, and then void main void while 1. So repeat forever. You go on doing that toggling. P1 equal to 0x55, then millisecond delay, and I have passed the argument as 250. So that many times it will get done. And secondly, it is P1 equal to 0xAA. So 0101 and 1011. So alternately, it will go on doing that. Again, same delay, MS delay 250. And as a delay routine, how we have written, just see. Simple one, unsigned integer, one variable I have used iTime, unsigned integer I, j, so for two counter purpose, two loops, and the outer loop is how many times you want to repeat based on the milliseconds requirement. So how many times we want? 250 times. So therefore I is equal to 0 to I less than IT time. I time, what it is going to catch, whatever that MS delay function when invoked is going to pass. MS delay function is passing argument, you can see in the main program, 250. So our outer loop, that is for I is equal to 0, I less than I time, that will get repeated 250 times. And the inner loop for J equal to 0 to J less than 1275 J plus plus. So that will get executed 1275 times. There is no special instruction in the loop, only these many times, the iteration. Okay, no pressure, no pressure, no pressure, like that. So means what? 1275 times multiplied by, for one cycle how much it takes? 8051, suppose if we consider the standard, the most frequently used crystal frequency 11.059 megahertz, So this 11.059 megahertz, accordingly our time is, standard time is 1.085 microseconds. So with 1.085 microseconds, approximately 1200 around, if we multiply by 1.085, so it approximately comes out to be 1 millisecond. So first of all, this j equal to 0 to j less than 1275 is going to produce approximately, when it gets multiplied by 1.085 microseconds, remember, please do listen properly and remember, 1275 is approximate number nearby 1000 something we want. So approximately, considering the execution time, the restriction of that particular machine, the C itself is going to add some internal delay parameter. So all these things, including that, this is a tentative figure. By trial and error, it has been derived 1275. When it gets multiplied by 1.085 microseconds, so it gives you approximately value which is very close to 1 millisecond. And we want 250 milliseconds, so our outer loop will multiply it by 250. So therefore 250 times it will get executed and we will get approximate delay of 250 milliseconds. So this is about this particular program. So the door sensor is connected to P1.1 pin and buzzer is connected to P1.7 right 8051C program to monitor the door sensor, and when it opens, sound the buzzer. You can sound the buzzer by sending a square wave of few hundred hertz. Same program, just I purposefully have taken this toggling kind of a program, because on off keying, on off, this kind of application is everywhere it is required, and controller based this activity is carried out, and it is very easy. So this, to understand that, since it is a frequently required and used kind of a, application as far as 8051 kind of a microcontroller is considered, so that's why I'm extending the same example in with different forms. Now here it is again MS delay, unsigned integer. So say for example, one sensor, door sensor, D sensor, name I have given, and I have used here data type S bit, that also I want to demonstrate as an illustration. So S bit D sensor P1.1, so that cap is indicating P1.1 input pin, and then buzzer is P1.7. and what is our program, what it is doing? First of all, door sensor is equal to 1, then while 1, that is go on doing this, check while D sensor is 1, so D sensor is equal to 1, then while it opens, meaning it's buzzer equal to 0, so whenever it is open, buzzer equal to 0, then allow some delay, MS delay 200, so 200 times 200 milliseconds approximately, and then buzzer equal to 1, and now turn on the buzzer, and again delay. So this on off, buzzer on, buzzer off, buzzer 0, buzzer 1, what it will produce? Square wave of same, since both 200 200, so same duty cycle, on and off period is same, 50%. So this way you can write a small program where this on off kind of a thing is illustrated. As far as logical operators are considered, then there is AND, OR, NOT, bitwise operators, AND, OR, XOR, inverter, there is a tilde operator, shift right, it is greater than, and shift left, it is less than. So this is equivalent to rotate instruction, RR and RL, the way we are using in assembly language. You can use these instructions, shift operator based instructions. These operators are widely used in software engineering or embedded system and control everywhere. Basically, they are from C, belonging to C environment. Bitwise logical operators for C. So here you can see A and B, A or B, vertical line, A cap kind of XOR, and that tilde operator, that is inversion. So this way you can use them. This is a small program. See here, 8051 program to convert packet BCD 0x29 to ASCII and display the bytes on P1 and P2. Packet BCD 29, we are going to first of all unpack it, and then separately on port 1 we are going to show one nibble, and on port 2 another nibble. So this is a task. Now see the program, void main, unsigned character, X, Y, Z, three variables I have used, unsigned character my byte, So 0x29, this is nothing but our original packed BCD number. Now as a first step, what is done? Just see x is equal to my byte, that means that particular number, and 0x0f. So and this particular number with 0x0f. Okay. Meaning is anding is done. So that 2 upper will get removed and only 9 will remain. So this is 09, it will give 09 because we are ending with upper portion, upper nibble is getting ended with 0 and the lower is going to get ended with f. So lower will be retained. Then p1 equal to x or symbol is there, 0x30. So as per our ASCII rule, digit 0 is 30, add 30. Digit 1 is 31, digit 2 is 32. So same. So here it will give you 39. And then next y equal to my byte. Whatever is there in the my byte now, and that you have to AND with 0xf0. So upper one 0f and lower one f0. So because of that, what will happen? Upper nibble will be retained and lower nibble will get cancelled because it is getting ended with 0. You can see the difference. And now what we are doing? Y is equal to y, right shift operator is shown, and how many times? 4 times. So right shift 4 times. So as if it is RR, rotate right 4 times. Similarly, it will happen without involvement of carry, and therefore the lower nibble will be to upper side, upper will be to lower side. So we get from the upper that upper nibble, because of ending operation in the previous step, we are getting 20, 2, 0, but we want 0, 2. So for that purpose, that 20 we have shifted 4 times, right shift, right or left, anything you can do. Ultimately the nibbles will get exchanged, similar to swap instruction. So it will become, instead of 20, now it will become 0, 2, and then add directly, send it to p2 port. P2 equal to y or with 0x30. This is a simple logic. Now if you want ASCII to get converted into BCD, reverse one. So how we can write? Just see, we have just assumed one number 4 and 7 ASCII digits and packed BCD and display them on P1 in the form of BCD. So program is reg51.h, unsigned character BCD byte, say for example, unsigned character W is equal to 4. So one number, that is one nibble, we are naming it as W, and that is 4. Another nibble is 7. Now first step, W is equal to W ended with 0x0f. Okay, so because of that, the 4 it will give you 0x0f, and we are writing W is equal to W less than 4. That means shift left. And instead of 40, now it will give you, instead of 04, it will give you 40. Getting? It has been shifted, left shifted. So we want lower nibble to upper side. So therefore we have done left shifting 4 times. And now Z is equal to Z ended with, in the Z we have 7 number. So that we are ending with 0x0f. So automatically that 7 will be retained. And the upper W is containing 40, and lower is containing 07. So BCD byte will be W or with Z. So that's why they will get combined, and the ASCII value will become 47. So packed BCD value will become 47. On port 1 we want to display, so therefore P1 equal to BCD byte, and that is 47. One more. Just see, just to illustrate all the operators, I have added this. So first instruction P0 0x35 ended with 0x0f, P1 0x04 ended with 0x68, ORing symbol, then XORing symbol, then inversion, then shifting right, say for example 3 times, shifting right 4 times, shifting left 4 times. So this way on different ports you can show whatever you want. So like that you can do n number of operations, and even ports you can involve. So that I want to show you. So therefore, directly in the immediate data, we have done the operations and answer is on the port itself. Now this is one more. Here what we are doing is hexadecimal number FD. We want to convert it into decimal. So what is the first step? Divide by 10. Check the remainder. If it is still smaller than, that is a modulus we are doing, divide by 10 and go on doing until it becomes less than 10. So since it is FD, so therefore we will do it 3 times because there will be a remainder. When first number is a bin byte, something name you can give, then it is equal to 0x FD, x is equal to bin byte divided by 10, first division. Then whatever is your D1, that means we are going to save, and whatever is the remainder, so again divide by 10, then again whatever is the remainder store in D2 and again divide by 10. So finally whatever you are getting, you shown different three ports, P0 equal to D1, P2, P1 equal to D2, P2 equal to D3. We will execute this so that you will better understand hex to decimal conversion program, because here as a part of slide I have not added any calculation and all that those things. So actually in the key environment itself we will execute that, and you refer that afterwards so as to get exactly how exactly you are going to get the answer. As far as 8051 compiler is considered, it allocates RAM locations bank 0, addresses 0 to 7, individual variables addresses 0, 8 and beyond, array elements addresses right after variables, and array elements need continuous RAM locations, and that limits the size of the array due to the fact that we have only 128 bytes of RAM for everything. And the stack, as far as considered, addresses right after array elements. So this is all about whatever basically we need as far as embedded C is considered. What is embedded C that we have seen means it is extension basically, and for getting the benefits of C language, all the benefits, as one of the richest kind of a platform or the environment which helps for IO programming, real-time programming, real-time hardware programming. So that's why we have used this embedded C platform. And data types are there, some sample programs, logical operators. These are certain things which frequently we use and we need them. So that's all as far as this session is considered. Whatever programs I illustrated just as a part of slide contains, all of them we will be having with our keel. So I will be demonstrating them at actual. We will go through the execution of those programs as well. Thank you.